Hello, 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 and welcome to PrivateEnglishPortal.com. My name is Steve Ford, and today I'm going to talk about time travel. Have you ever felt amazed how technological advances have been picking up speed in the last 30 years? Just between you and me, all of my online students find having one-to-one English lessons with me a snap. Once upon a time, before the internet, they had no choice but to go by car, sometimes driving long distances through traffic and bad weather, trying to squeeze into a parking space, taking their heavy books with them to a classroom packed with other people, to have a chance to be in contact with a teacher to learn. Now, thanks to present-day technology, they can comfortably sit back and relax in their homes or workstations and have classes one-to-one with me. That's something they could only dream of in the past. It was something I could only dream about 5 years back. Before starting Private English Portal on YouTube, I was always pressed for time. For example, I've lost count of the number of times I got caught in traffic and I ended up arriving in the nick of time to give class. Sometimes I wish I could have pressed a magic button to make my car fold up into the palm of my hand so I could put it in my pocket and just walk away from those awful traffic jams. Yes, time after time, so many people are dazzled, blown away by such technological miracles. If we think for a moment, life has changed just like that. Latest research shows that with all of the time-saving gadgets we have, we can squeeze our daily tasks into 24 hours. Which would have taken 31 hours 10 years ago. Instead of 24/7, we now have the ability to go 31/7. Well, if you're younger, you might not have noticed. But ask your parents or your grandparents or your great-grandparents about the changes they've seen since technology started to take off. They can tell you, for example, that they remember how difficult it used to be to do research for homework assignments from school. Before we started using online research, we had been doing it the old-fashioned way. 30 years ago, a person most certainly would have needed to find a library nearby and spend hours on end searching for information among all the countless books and encyclopedias. Today, it only takes a few seconds to type the question and Google it. The answer pops up right before your eyes. So science fiction has become science fact. For example, who could have imagined opening a package of frozen food, putting it in a small box, and abracadabra, it's ready in 3 minutes. No one could have. But that's what a lot of people do every day when they use their microwave ovens. And it's the same with cell phones, smartphones, laptops, tablets, electric vehicles, so on and so forth. There is a long list. Now imagine someone from the 80s watching a commercial about technology
from 2012.
The 80s people would just flip over how tiny computers have got. People walking around with their iPhones and tablets, doing things wirelessly. They'd say something like, "No way, get out of town. That guy's reading a book, watching a movie, listening to an MP3, and talking on the phone? Get real. Talk about multitasking." Well, let's put you, the viewer, in the shoes of a time traveler. Get set as we fast forward to the commercials of the future. Let's say 30 years from now. Imagine that we can create, right here and now,
a spaceship to travel to the future in 2042.
I wonder what we'll find there. Let's do it.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome aboard Peppy Space Travel. Our destination today is for the year 2042. We will be swinging around the sun momentarily. I would like to remind you that all cell phones and related portable devices do not need to be turned off, as they won't work in the future. All crew, please take your seats as we count down. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, engage. Sun at sublight speed. Current outer space temperature is 427 degrees Celsius. Engage. Mercury. Venus. Earth. Mars. Jupiter. Saturn. Engage. Gentlemen, on behalf of all of us, thank you for flying on Peppy Space Travel. Your tour guide will be with you shortly.
Welcome to the future. First, let's talk about teletransportation.
You thought downloading was cool? Imagine you're in New York City and your friend is in Moscow. You're chatting away with him as you chow down on some pizza. With our new teletransport device, you can download anything, including your friend's pizza, in 3 minutes flat. Would you like to cut down on shipping time? Tired of waiting for weeks on end to get that product you ordered online? Now with Teletransport 3.0, you can use our state-of-the-art technology to transport whatever you want, whenever you want, 24/7. Pizza never tasted so teletransport good. Tasty.
And speaking of pizza, why not try our food replicator?
Food Creator 1.0. Are you tired of eating junk food, getting overweight? Would you like to have more time on your hands? Tired of not being able to fit into your skinny jeans? with our user-friendly voice-activated food printer. You ask for any replicated food from a wide variety of menu choices. Pizza, spaghetti, noodles, hamburgers, steak, you name it. The time-saving food creator will make it for you. With Food Creator 1.0, we use an eco-friendly based nutrient solution called I'm Not a Couch Potato for a completely balanced eating experience. You will save yourself a trip to the supermarket, and you'll never have to lift a finger again to cook things yourself. Just say, I want a chocolate sundae, and Food Creator will do the rest by creating a tasty and oh-so-mouth-watering dessert at 40 calories per printout. We're certain you'll fall in love with our product, and for this reason, we are including free of charge the Food Creator 1.0 Gourmet Plugin. Tired of dining out? With this gourmet plugin, you can impress your friends and family by creating gourmet meals at a fraction of the cost. Save your time, save your money, and lose weight with a smile on your face. If you need a little entertainment for your dinner, how about
virtual pop stars?
Ever since way back in the old days of 2008, during the presidential elections, CNN broadcasted holograms of people reporting on the news. Then came the 3D holographic cartoon pop sensation in Japan. Now, our hippest and hottest virtual pop stars in 2041 go on tour and perform live on stage, just like a human pop star. Hear, feel, and even touch our cutting-edge holographic pop stars. After the Virtue show, you can always ask the Virtue pop star for an autograph. No fan gets missed. Are you a record producer that wants to cut down on costs? Well, now you can save millions of dollars by not having to pay your pop star, because our virtual pop stars work for free! For a small extra performance fee, you can broadcast your own private performance for friends and family. An awesome birthday gift. And that's not all. Just to show how sure we are that you will love Virtual Pop Star 3.0, we are throwing in Virtue Retro Star for free. Yes, that's right, for free. You can bring back your favorite singers who have already died using our Retropop plugin. Take a walk down memory lane and see, feel, and party like there's no tomorrow with your favorite idols of yesterday.
Thank you for visiting the future. All passengers now boarding Peppy's spaceship.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Peppy's spaceship. We hope you enjoyed your visit. Our current ETA to the present is approximately 50 seconds. We would like to remind you at this time that any souvenirs bought at the duty-free shop must be handed over to our flight attendants so as not to alter the present. Crew, please take your seats as we count down. 3, 2, 1. Engage.
Welcome back to the present.
Well, everybody, it's good to be back here in the present. That was fun. Time traveling with the whole world. I want to do it again. If we time travel to the future again, I will invite you personally so we can explore the mysteries of the future together. I don't know about you, but I want some pizza. This whole time traveling thing makes you hungry.
Grammar notes. Past perfect.
Past perfect. At the beginning of the video, I said, before we started using online research, we had been doing it the old-fashioned way with books. Here is an example of the past perfect, continuous or progressive. Simply put, we use the past perfect progressive to show one action that was in progress before another action happened. It's the same idea for the past perfect.
By the time she arrived, I had already made dinner with Food Creator 1.0.
So what happened first? It's I already had made dinner, then after she arrived. Look for the clues to know which action happened first. In this case, it's already. Past perfect shows which action happened first in a sequence of two actions that happened in the past. Remember that. Try to use this grammar. I know that a lot of you have studied it time and time again. We use it, and I know a lot of you out there are afraid to use it. But it is only when we try new things that we learn how to make mistakes and learn from those mistakes. Whatever doesn't kill you makes you stronger, right?
Using by the time for different verb tenses.
A great time phrase, by the time, and it can be used with many different verb tenses. By the time this year is over, I will have been teaching for over 20 years. Go figure. By the time virtual pop stars arrived on the pop scene, Japan had already had its first cartoon virtual pop star. By the time you get this message, I will be getting on a space shuttle to Mars. Well, now I can see we've run out of time, and I'd like to thank you for traveling a little bit in time here today in Peppy 24. Have a great day. Bye-bye. Do 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 do
Past perfect. Watch the sequence, it's not really hard to find. Past perfect happened first, then came the past perfect. Watch the sequence, it's not really hard to find. Past perfect happened first, then came the past. Past perfect happened first, then came the past. Past perfect happened first, then came the two.